We discovered it kind of accidentally, my doctor and I. Took some x-rays and finally said, there's something we don't like about the pictures of your lungs.
I've been diagnosed now with asbestosis. I never had a problem with it before. I'm wasting away. I've lost about 50 pounds in the last 4 months.
How's this changed your retirement? Instead of going out doing stuff, you're sitting at home all the time, you can't leave the house. Can't pack nothing. You can't walk.
Can't do much anymore. There's nothing they can do about it, really. I think it's just the lungs are shot.
My name is Doug Jones. I'm the president of Local 480 of the United Steelworkers in Trail. Asbestos is the number one occupational killer in BC today. But in 2002, the Gordon Campbell Liberals changed the WCB Act. One of these changes prevents any retiree over the age of 65 from receiving a disability award for any illness, injury, or disease. Sadly, an asbestos-related disease takes up to 40 years to become detectable. This change is one of many that seriously undermines health and safety for workers in BC, adding insult to injury. We hope you'll think about this on May 12th.
Asbestos was a miracle ore that was pulled from the ground that was found to be fire protective or preventive. What has happened over the years is many workers have become exposed to it and exposed to high degrees of it. When you get cancer from asbestos mesothelioma, it's an extremely painful and it's a terminal disease. I recently was up in Trail, Madam Speaker, and I met with some workers that worked in the smelter up in Trail, and I think there are about 36 of them that have active cases. I think 35 now, one just passed away. Some of them are spending their last years of their lives in extreme pain and extreme agony.
Especially in the carpenter shop, I cut that the asbestos came like a 4-bed sheets of plywood. And I made the insulating blocks for the old malting room. And cutting this material on a saw, lots of dust.
Some of those buildings up there were from the original ones. They were tearing down and redoing. So you didn't really know what you were getting into.
But everywhere you went, there was asbestos sheets 4 feet wide. You need a chunk?
This is a cancer that is on the outside of the lung. And,
well, it penetrated, probably.
It is definitely from having worked with asbestos. His right lung right now is collapsed. It's not functioning. He's been through chemo. He's been through some radiation. He's just come to basically a halt now. He's having pain. He's on morphine. He's on painkillers. He's on his oxygen pretty well 24 hours. Mm. When it came down to compensation, they said their hands were tied because of the legislation that Premier Campbell's government, my premier, had introduced. Somebody has to be accountable. They're calling it a devastating work-related illness. And if it was work-related, and he was sent to those places to work in those hazardous conditions, and this is the result, then should there not be some compensation for this?
They seem to have taken the compensation out of workers' compensation when they've gone to WorkSafe BC. And that is a travesty, and it's something that needs to be corrected. And it needs to be looked at that this is about these men, their families, their children, their grandchildren, and their families' futures. And it's a sad situation that we just can't tolerate in this province.
The people that worked at Teck Comminco and were exposed to asbestos, some of them are spending their last breaths fighting a system when they should be spending their retirement with some dignity with their grandchildren and gardening. And so it's very sad that the employers are getting a holiday from this exposure and the workers are spending their last days fighting it in pain and agony, and that has to change.
Recognize those that have passed on the job. They've given their life, through no fault of their own, just worker safety, and I'm here to be an advocate on their behalf and make sure that health and safety prevails.
Gordon Campbell may be tossing and turning at night over his deficit budget, but I predict he has not lost a minute of sleep since he cut one-third of WCB regulations, slashed loss of earning benefits, or cut rehabilitation services for injured workers. Remember, British Columbia is open for business, he told us. That was the government's backdrop to slashing hundreds of WCB and employment standards protections, benefits, and staff.
They watered down the regulations. They watered down the compensation claims. They look the other way when people are dying. At the end of the day, we cannot tolerate this any longer. Sisters and brothers, if we're going to stop the carnage, then we must get rid of this government in Victoria. It is fundamentally important to do that if we want workers to be safe.